Local consumers may find less supply of canned sardines in the market after some manufacturers closed up shop. Joyce Balancho tells us why.
There is insufficiency in the supply of canned sardines in the Philippine market that is caused not by the lack of fish catch, but of companies leaving the canning business due to profit loss. This is according to the Canned Sardine Association of the Philippines, or CSAP. Asked how many have shut down operations, CSAP refused to give details due to the possible breach of confidentiality. CSAP Executive Director Francisco Buencamino said he will meet with Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual on Monday to discuss the issue. On Wednesday, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. attended the inauguration of a newly constructed manufacturing plant of Mega Prime Foods in Santo Tomas City, Batangas. In his speech, the president said he hoped that the new plant would help address the insufficient supply of canned sardines in the local market.
This plant will help meet the rising local demand for sardines, with its expected capacity to produce more than 11,600 metric tons. This fills up 27% of our local supply insufficiency in canned sardines. This will greatly contribute to our efforts in ensuring food security and making seafood more convenient to consume for families across the country.
The chief executive also lauded the company for employing thousands of Filipino workers and providing livelihood opportunities to local communities. According to Mega Prime Foods, the new plant in Batangas alone would create an additional 1,000 jobs for the locals.
It is an example of what we in agriculture and agribusiness are hoping to demonstrate to all our investors, the ability to scale up from what can be a backyard kind of business, slowly building it up to a very modern and very, very high production capacity like we see here today.
Meanwhile, the company's executives assure consumers that while they continue to expand their business, their products will remain affordable to every Filipino.
We are also subsidizing some of the increase. As much as possible, we don't want to increase the price because we want to help the Filipino people. That's our commitment to the Filipinos. As long as we can, we will hold the price increase.
The plant began operations Wednesday and it is expected to generate 600,000 cans daily. The company has also opened its facility for free educational tours to inspire students to venture into this industry. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
President Marcos Jr. sees no need for additional powers to curb inflation. This is in response to a proposal by Marikina Representative Stella Kimbo, who said additional powers for Marcos would help stabilize food prices, as well as fight hoarding and price manipulation. But the president says, as Agriculture Secretary, there are some factors that he cannot control.
If we declare an emergency, I have already the power to declare an emergency and to control the prices of commodities. So I don't think there is any need for more than that. That is sufficient. Noong February, hindi pa bumababa masyadong fuel prices at ngayon pa lang natin inaayos yung food supply para yung inflation na galing sa agricultural products ay mabawasan. Wala tayong magagawa sa fuel, wala tayong magagawa doon sa mga iba't ibang inputs.
Inflation in the Philippines reached a fresh 14-year high of 8.7% in January. The Philippine Central Bank expects it to rise further, even hitting up to 9.3% in February.
The Philippines' budget deficit widened to 378.4 billion pesos in December last year. That's nearly 12% higher than the amount in the same period a year ago. It also pushes the total budget deficit in 2022 to 1.61 trillion pesos. But the Treasury Bureau says the 2022 total is within the program deficit of 1.65 trillion pesos. An economist, meanwhile, said the December deficit is the widest on record on a monthly basis. RCBC's Michael Ricafort attributes this to rising commodity prices and the weaker peso.
Town officials in the Philippine province of Zamboanga del Norte denounced the massive destruction of a mountaintop forest in their area. This report tells us a firm that was newly granted an exploration permit is already conducting mining operations there.
This is Mount Mona Lisa in the municipality of Gotalac in the southern province of Zamboanga del Norte. It is blanketed with lush forests and surrounded by rich waters. But it is slowly changing following the approval of exploration activities for mineral resources. In videos obtained by ABS-CBN News, trees have been uprooted, upland areas have been flattened, and a nearby water source has also been affected. The exploration activities are being undertaken by the Florhenmar Mining and Development Corporation, or FMDC, and its contractor Zamboanga Nickel Corporation after securing a permit from the Mines and Geosciences Bureau in Zamboanga Peninsula Region. Based on FMDC's application proposal, it wants to check for minerals in the area. The National Commission on Indigenous Peoples in the Zamboanga Peninsula has approved exploration in the area after the company and indigenous peoples there supposedly reached a mutual understanding. However, an inspection by the local government showed the contractor is doing more than just exploration.
Ang amin lang is i-provide lang yung mga requirements na ngayon hindi wala silang papel tapos binubuldos na nila lang area. Nakagawa na sila ng causeway, Philippine Ports Authority. Wala pa silang in-issue or na-approve na mag-conduct na sila or mag-construct na sila ng yung port.
Kulang po yung mga dokumento.
Walang dokumento, as in, wala.
Gotalac Mayor Eddie Kimbo insists work being done in the area poses a danger to indigenous people while also adversely affecting their livelihood.
Sa baba, nandun yung mga residente, population ng barangay Bakong. Pag may malakas na ulan, ilang araw na ulan o bagyo, ikawawa yung nasa baba. Si Bako na mag-landslide, ubos sila lahat. Masakit sa loob ko kasi yung mga tao ko, mga tao natin, wala nang mahuli na mga pangkabuhayan nila. Gaya ng octopus, isda.
Village officials have passed several resolutions opposing activities in the area, an ancestral land being claimed by the Subanen indigenous group. Residents also submitted a manifesto to Malacañang calling for an end to what they call as mining activities. MGB Zamboanga Peninsula Regional Director Hernani Abdon confirms FMDC has an exploration permit. Abdon also says he's aware of the illegal mining claims but investigations are still ongoing. The offices of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources in Gotalac and Zamboanga Peninsula have yet to respond to requests for an interview. However, a document from the DENR obtained by ABS-CBN News shows FMDC and its contractor is conducting site development which involves bunkhouses and other facilities. The DENR has suggested to MGB to issue a cease and desist order against the site development. Officials from the DENR central office have declined to answer media questions. ABS-CBN News also tried to get FMDC and Zamboanga Nickels to comment, but they are not responding to calls and texts.
Officials in the Philippine province of Oriental Mindoro are asking for more help to contain an oil spill caused by a sunken oil tanker. Fisher folk also worried about their livelihood after the Philippine Coast Guard banned fishing activities near the affected waters. Details from Dennis Datu.
Aerial footage at Ujan, Oriental Mindoro, where the tanker MQ Princess Empress capsized early Tuesday morning. The vessel is carrying 800,000 liters of industrial fuel. According to the Philippine Coast Guard, diesel leaking from the ship's engine has caused 6-kilometer-long oil leak. They have yet to install an oil spill boom in the area because they are still looking for the submerged ship. The Coast Guard's Marine Environmental Protection Unit has sprayed chemicals and deployed machines that can absorb the oil.
Hindi naman siya ganun ka-itim, parang naghalo-halo na siya na fuel.
Meanwhile, local officials are worried the oil spill might damage marine protected areas, especially the Verde Island Passage, known as the world center of marine biodiversity.
Ang bayan ng Nauhan ay may tatlo kaming marine protected area na nandun sa coastal area din, nasa Barangay Herrera, Masaging, at saka doon sa...
Kaya na magiging epekto nito sa mga minister natin. We're doing now yung
bubuo nung team na una, merong mga makakapagawa, yung mga experts coming from the side of DNR and the consultants coming from the private sector, kasi pinupush na rin na even yung mga experts from the private sector yung makatudo natin.
Representatives from DNR EMB have gathered water samples from parts of Nauhan and from the marine protected areas to check if oil have reached these areas. Fisher folk are also worried about their livelihood after the PCG banned fishing activities near the affected waters. A crisis management committee has also been formed. The owner of the submerged marine vessel vows to cooperate with authorities to minimize the effects of the oil spill to the affected communities. Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News, Nauhan Oriental, Mindoro.